very important. Most important, number two, is social distancing. Keeping that distance between yourself and others as much as you possibly can. That is critically important and has been shown in other countries and other cities, counties, and states across the nation to be the one way that we can really avoid transmitting COVID-19 and try to stop it in its tracks. Number three is collect and quarantine. Now, clearly, we don't have a lot of ability to collect. We're just getting the supplies for that here in the county. And we're standing up tomorrow a collection site at Raymond James. Some of the other hospitals have been doing collections. BayCares and Tampa General have been doing outstanding jobs, as have Advent and HCA. But we are still nowhere near testing the number of individuals that we need to, and that's because we don't have the collection supplies. Once the collections are done, then we're quarantining people, and that is the goal: keep individuals away from others. Very, very important. And then lastly, we want everyone to stay aware, stay connected, stay calm, and stay kind. We want to make kindness more contagious than COVID-19. Very, very important. Most of you saw at the EPG meeting yesterday where I tried to get the rest of the group to vote on a stay-at-home order. That was voted down. They instead chose to come back and look at a curfew, which in my opinion is more restrictive than a stay-at-home order, because a curfew, you have to be at home during specific hours, and the stay-at-home, you can actually have the freedom to move about as long as you have that social distancing. So let me talk a little bit about the stay-at-home and what that entails, because I think that individuals are making it a little bit more complicated and difficult than it really needs to be. So the stay-at-home order means that you still have the freedom to move about. All of those services that you need will still be open, be able to go to the grocery store, to the pharmacy, you know, whatever you need to do, gas station, you can go out and exercise, you can do what needs to be done as long as you have that social distancing. So that's very, very important. As far as what type of businesses can stay open, the simplest way to look at it is that any business where you can have that social distance would be okay to operate. Restaurants were closed down because everybody was in close proximity. So we had to close those down, but still have the carry out and delivery options available. So it's very important. So that, in a nutshell, is the stay at home order. There are a lot of exemptions. We're going to have all of that up on our website very soon. So it's very simple. It's just the next step to take to try to keep our community safe. I happened to speak with officials from San Francisco yesterday. They were one of the first cities that put a stay-at-home order in place. At the time, it was a shelter-in-place was what it was called at that particular time. Shelter-in-place, stay-at-home, safer at home, they're all really the same thing. They enacted it when they had 41 cases in their community, and now they were one of the first ones to do it way back. And now they only have 100 cases. So although they're not confident that they were able to completely flatten that curve, they believe that that is a major factor in the flattening of the curve and not having as many cases as they anticipated. That's what all of the medical experts are saying, that you have to keep individuals away from each other. As I've said all along, the seriousness of the COVID virus isn't necessarily in the virus itself and the effects on an individual unless you're in those high-risk categories. The severity of it is in the ease with which it is transmitted. So if we can stay away from each other, stay clear, then we'll be able to avoid transmitting it. Now, I know a lot of you guys have been home. You've been home with the family. You've been home with the kids. Our amazing Parks and Rec department is coming up with incredibly innovative ideas of things that you can do while you're at home. Not being a creative individual myself, you can't count on me for that. So our Parks and Recreation group are going to be putting those things up on our website. We want everybody to text Tampa Ready or Tampa Lista for Spanish-speaking citizens to 888-777. Go to our website, tampagov.net. It's got everything you need to know on there in English and in Spanish. And also, if you need to talk to someone, you have questions, you can call our call center, which has been up for close to a week now. And the number there is 833-TPA-INFO. 833-TPA-INFO. So again, we need our community to be safe. A lot of people don't realize how big our county is. We have an estimated 1.4 million residents, which literally makes Hillsborough County bigger than 10 other states in the United States.